We all know that we live in a three-dimensional space. There are some theories suggesting that the universe has more than three dimensions. But even if more dimensions exist, would we understand it? Let's discuss the possibility of more than three dimensions in today's video of DiscoverZen. We generally interact with all objects in three-dimensional space. Or do we? Even if we can see something which has more than three dimensions, our brain will perceive it as a three-dimensional object. Our brain can't directly process any object with more dimensions. In that case, our brain breaks that object down to 3D to understand it. Some studies even suggest that our universe is only made of three spatial dimensions, and also argues that if higher dimensions existed, we would not see them, and light exists only in three dimensions, as far as we know. String theory suggests that space-time can be 10-dimensional, meaning 9 spatial dimensions and 1 time dimension. Some of the other theories even suggest that we can have more than 20 dimensions. For this video, let's just look at the dimensional aspects proposed in string theory. One dimension is a single line, where you can go left and right, or vice versa. When we add a point perpendicular to it and stretch the line sideways to that point, we get a plane with two dimensions. In this dimension, we can move anywhere on a plane. Now add another point perpendicular to the plane, stretch the plane so that you can move left and right, front and back, as well as up and down. This has now become a three-dimensional space. Our current understanding of science stops here. We can go further and say that four dimensions can be the 3D object stretched to a point perpendicular to it, but there's a problem. With our current understanding, we can't perceive the object in the 4D, and the same applies to the further dimensions. It's valid with mathematics, but we can't really interpret them. We can say that every lower dimension consists inside its subsequent one, but that will give us a possibility of infinite dimensions, which is the craziest idea to imagine. Some people say that time is the fourth dimension, but the problem with time is that it is not spatial. And that's the reason we have a special time dimension in the proposal of string theory. Now let's speculate some of the amazing ideas that can be observed with more dimensions. According to superstring theory, the fifth and sixth dimensions are where the notion of possible worlds arise. If we're able to see through to the fifth dimension, we might see a world slightly different from our own. This would give us a means of measuring the similarity and differences between our world and other possible ones. In the sixth dimension, we will see a plane of possible worlds where we can compare and position all the possible universes that start with the same initial conditions as this one, that is, the Big Bang. In theory, if you could master the fifth and sixth dimensions, you could travel back in time or go to different futures. In the seventh dimension, you have access to the possible worlds that start with different initial conditions. In the fifth and sixth, the initial conditions were the same and subsequent actions were different. Here, everything is different from the beginning of time. The eighth dimension again gives us a plane of such possible universe histories. Each of the possible universes begins with different initial conditions and branches out infinitely, hence why they are called infinities. In the ninth dimension, we can compare all the possible universe histories, starting with all the different possible laws of physics and initial conditions. In the tenth and final dimension, we arrive at the point in which everything possible and imaginable is covered. According to M theory, which unifies all consistent versions of the superstring theory, we can hypothesize up to the 11th dimension. Anything after the 11th dimension will fall under the category of 10th or 11th dimension, even if it's perceivable by some means, which is unlikely from current standards. Now let's speculate a different scenario, like, what if we could use wormholes for teleportation? That sounds like a different topic to speculate and investigate on DiscoverZen.